Okay. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me. I'm very glad to stay in Tel Aviv again and to give a talk here. So I will speak on the connection between commuting difference operators and commuting differential operators. My talk is based on these papers. In the beginning, I would like to explain some basic results, classical results related to commuting ordering differential operators. And after that, I explain our results. Okay, let's start from the Schur lemma. Let us assume that we have two differential operators. And the commutativity condition of these two operators is a very complicated system of nonlinear differential equations on coefficients u and v. Probably the first non-trivial results belongs to Isai Schur. He proved the following statement. Let us assume that we have three operators, Ln, Lm, and Ls. And let us assume that Ln commutes with Lm and Ln commutes with Ls. Then it's turned out from here, it follows that Lm commutes with Ls. To prove this lemma, Schur used formal pseudo-differential operators. Pseudo-differential operator, formal pseudo-differential operator is a sum of some abstract differential operator plus infinite tail with negative powers of d. And in particular, he proved that if we have a differential operator of order n, then there exists pseudo formal pseudo differential operator s such that if we take, if we consider conjugation of ln with s, we obtain a differential operator with constant coefficient. And if we apply this s to lm, we obtain some formal pseudo differential operator of order l, of order m. And if you write the condition that ln tilde and lm tilde commute, then from all that have constant coefficients. And a similar argument, if you apply s to ls, ls tilde also has constant coefficients. And from here it follows that lm and ls commute. So this is very beautiful theorem. Probably the next very interesting and important results belongs to Burchnow and Chowdhury. They prove the following. If you have two commuting differential operators, ln and lm, then there exists a non-zero polynomial q of z and w such that q of ln and lm is equal to zero. For example, if we take these two differential operators, then one can check that L2 to the power 3 is equal to L3 to the power 2. Hence, q is z to the power 3 minus w to the power 2. This polynomial Q defines affine spectral curve. This is zeros of polynomial Q. And spectral curve parameterize common eigen values of these two operators. More precisely, if we have a common eigenfunction psi for Ln and Lm, and if we consider corresponding eigenvalues Z and W, then it's turned out that the point with coordinates Z and W belongs to our spectral curve. There are two main situations. First situation is the following. If we fixed eigenvalues Z and W, and if we calculate the dimension of space of common eigenfunctions, this dimension is called rank of This number is the same for the point with coordinate z and w in the general position. More precisely, if the point with coordinate z and w is non-singular, then L is the same. In singular points, the dimension can be different. And in the case of rank one, function psi can be found explicitly in terms of theta function. This formula was found by Krechevier. So roughly speaking, we have the following picture. If we have differential commuting differential operator, then we have a spectral curve. And for every point of the spectral curve corresponds the space of common eigenfunctions. So we have a vector bundle over our spectral curve. And the dimension of this fiber is a rank of the pair. In the case of rank one, as I said, common eigenfunction can be found by the following way. For this, we should take a spectral data. Spectral data consists of compact irreducible algebraic curve gamma. For simplicity, one can assume that gamma is a Riemann surface of genus G. We should fix a point Q on gamma, local parameter k minus one in the neighborhood of point Q. And additionally, we should take points gamma one, gamma G in general position. Then there exists a unique Baker-Hazen function which depends on X and point of spectral curve P such that in the neighborhood of point Q, it has essential singularity of exponential type. And the second condition is that a function psi has simple poles in gamma one, gamma g from our spectral data. And how to construct commuting differential operators. For this, we should take a meromorphic function on a spectral curve gamma with a unique pole at our point Q. We have a formal series, Laurent series for function f. Then we can construct a formal differential operator such that the difference between left hand side and f multiplied by psi is equal to this term. It's easy to see from the definition of Baker-Hazen function. For example, if we multiply f by psi, then the main term of this multiplication in the neighborhood of point Q is equal to k to the power n e kx plus multiplied by O of one. And the same asymptote has nth derivative of psi. K to the power n e to the power kx O of one. And if you take a difference between this part and this part, we obtain asymptotic k to the power n minus one e to the power kx O of one with some coefficients u n minus one of x. These coefficients depends on Baker-Hazer function. And as I said, we can find formal differential operator such we have this identity. But this term is equal to zero, because if it is not equal to zero, we can add this term to the Baker-Hazer function. And we have a contradiction with the uniqueness of Baker-Hazer function. So we have this identity. And if we take another meromorphic function g of p with the same pole at point Q, we have such identity, and from these two identities, it follows that Ln and Lm commute, because from these two identities, it follows that psi belongs to the kernel of the commutator. But commutator has finite dimensional kernel, but here we have infinite dimensional kernel. It is possible only if the commutator is equal to zero. And the simplest example is the following. If we take an elliptic spectral curve, then if you take such function psi here, zeta of z is a Weierstrass function, and sigma of z also is a Weierstrass function. Zeta has a simple pole at zero, and sigma has a simple zero at q. And from the definition zeta and sigma, it follows that it is periodic function, double periodic function. And this function satisfies all conditions from the definition of the Baker-Hazen function. And if we take a meromorphic function on spectral curve by function of Weierstrass, it has pole of order 2 at q, then we have such identity. So this is the simple case of the Lamé operator. And this operator commutes with the operator of order 3 on the left hand side. Yes. Okay.
What's the point?
Just a second. In these identities, we have two functions, z and w on gamma. And these two functions are meromorphic on this gamma. Z has a pole of order n at infinity, and W has a pole of order m at infinity.
Q is infinity,
yes, here.
There might be more than one.
Sorry?
There might be more than one point.
No. By Kretschewer theorem, this spectral curve has only one. For quantification, we should take only one point at infinity. This is a statement of Kretschewer. It is not obvious. It falls from his construct. Yes, commuting differential, ordinary commuting differential, right one. And let me recall one very beautiful result of Novikov. Let us assume that we have a periodic one-dimensional Schrodinger operator, dx to the power 2 minus u, and we assume that u is a real function, periodic real function. We say that eigenvalues lambda belongs to Fourier spectrum if there is block function corresponding to these eigenvalues. And eigenfunction psi is called block function if we add to the argument period tau, it multiplied by e to the power ip. Here p is a real number. So such function is called block function. And we say that lambda belongs to Fourier spectrum if there is block function corresponding to this eigenvalue. And the operator L2 is called finite gap if the spectrum consists of finite number of numbers of intervals. And one of them must be a half infinite. Novikov proved that if one dimensional Schrödinger operator commutes with an operator of order 2g plus 1, then L2 is a finite gap operator. And Dubroin proved the inverse statement. An example of finite gap operator is the Lamé operator. if you take Weierstrass pi function and if you assume that the lattice is invariant under the real involution, then pi function is a real function. And if we add to argument a half period, we obtain smooth real periodic potential. And it's turned out this is an example of finite gap operator. And during a long, very big period of time, it was known only one example of finite gap operator. This is the Lamé operator. And Novikov proved if L2 commutes with L2G plus one, then it is a finite gap. And it's Matveev found explicit formulas for potentials of one-dimensional finite gap Schrödinger operator. It can be expressed in terms of theta function of Jacobi variety of this hyperelliptic spectral curve. And this is very nice construction. Another example of finite gap operator is a Trebisch-Verdier operator. The potential also is given in explicit form. Ij is an integer number. And I would like to say several words about higher rank operators. The first example of higher rank operators was obtained by Deximier. So this is two operators of order 4 and order 6. These operators commute, and these two operators gives us an example of commutative subalgebra in the first real algebra. And spectral curve for these two operators is elliptic spectral curve. Krechwer and Novikov found all operators of rank 2 corresponding to elliptic spectral curve. In the partial case when operator of order 4 is formally self-adjoint operator, it has very simple form. Here W is an arbitrary functional parameter and U is expressed through W by this formula. Here F1 is a polynomial of degree 3, which defines a spectral curve of L4 and commuting operator L6. And for L6, it is also given by this formula. Another example is given in this theorem. This operator commutes this operator of order 4g plus 2. And spectral curve here is hyperelliptic curve of genus g. This is another example of commutative subalgebra of the first real algebra. And now let me explain some results on difference operators. And after that, I explain a connection between commuting differential operators and difference operators. Difference operators have such form. Here, T is a shift operator. It acts on function of f of n as a shift, and u and v are some functions on z. And if you write a commutativity condition of lk and ls, we again obtain very complicated nonlinear system of difference equations on coefficients u and v. Here we have also a spectral curve. It's to know that if LK and LS commute, then there exists a polynomial F of Z and W such that F of LK and LS is equal to zero. And similar, we can define a spectral curve as a zeros of our polynomial F. And again, if we consider common eigenfunctions, eigenfunction, then the corresponding eigenvalues gives us a point on spectral curve gamma. And similarly, we can define a rank of this pair as a dimension of space of common eigenfunctions for fixed Z and W. But here, your question is very interesting. For difference operator, this affine spectral curve generally can be complexified by M points. This is the main difference between a difference case and differential case. And this when we compactify our spectral curve by M points, such operators are called M point operators. And what is known in this theory? Operators of rank one, 2 point operators of rank were found by Krechevier and independently by Mumford. And eigenfunctions of such operators can be expressed in terms of theta function of Jacobi variety of the spectral curve. And Krechevier and Novikov found 1 point operators of rank greater than one. But all of this operator cannot be applicable to find a connection between commuting differential operators and difference operators. And it is strange, but Krechevier and Novikov did not consider one important case when we have 1 point operators of rank one. And I would like to explain this case. Such operators can be reconstructed from the following spectral data. We should take a spectral curve gamma of genus G, marked point Q, local parameter K to the power minus one in the neighborhood point Q, points gamma one, gamma G in general position. This is very similar to the differential case. And additionally, we take a point PN in general position. Then we can define a set of rational functions on our spectral curve. We fixed integer number n, let's n is positive. Then there exists a unique rational function which has a pole of order n in point Q, poles in gamma one, gamma G, and zeros in P1 and Pn from in the points from our spectral data. And additionally, it has a point zeros and points gamma one, gamma G, and similar when n is negative. And the second condition, we assume that our function psi is normalized by this formula. Then this function is there exists and unique, but it follows from for example, Riemann-Roch theorem. Then absolutely similar to the differential case of rank one, if we take two meromorphic functions f and g of order m and s, then there are two difference operators of such form such that lm psi is equal to f psi and ls psi is equal to g psi, and lm and ls commute. And how to find examples of such operators?
Yes,
It follows on the from the Riemann-Roch theorem. Explain. I will explain the argument. We find coefficients of this operator such that to Q order of pole in point Q, and we construct by induction these coefficients, and after that coefficient, and if we apply this operator to psi, we obtain a rational function which has poles only point gamma one, gamma g. But on the algebraic curve of genus Z, G for non-spatial divisor gamma one, gamma g, there is no meromorphic function with the pole in these points. Yes, of course, I should start from the t to the power m. To Q asymptotic k to the power m plus one, n. For example, Kreutzwieler construction two points operators correspond to the case when P1, Pn are the same. In this case, we obtain Kreutzwieler's two points operators. Maybe you wish. And how to construct examples of such operators? Let's consider hyperelliptic curve, and we assume that Q is infinite point. Then by our theorem, we take two meromorphic functions of this hyperelliptic curve, Z and W. Z has a pole of order two at infinity, and W has a pole of order to G plus one at infinity. Then to psi corresponds operator of order two. We write it in such form, t plus un to the power two plus w. And to find operators, we make the following. We consider factorization of L2 minus Z by two terms. One of them is t minus chi, where chi is psi at the point n plus one divided by psi of n. And if you apply L2 minus Z to psi, you obtain zero. From this definition of chi. And from the properties of psi, it follows that chi has such form where Q is a polynomial of order G in Z, and S is Q is polynomial of order G in S, and S also is polynomial of order G in Z. And if you write this identity, from this identity, it follows that the polynomial S satisfy this equation. And so now that this equation is equivalent to the commutativity condition of L2 and L to G plus one. And if we solve this equation, this equation on coefficients of polynomial Ln, Sn. And if we solve this equation, we obtain our operator L2 and L to G plus one. It is a remarkable fact that this equation can be linearized with respect to S. If we replace here by n plus one and take a difference to this equation, then the difference is divisible by Sn, and we obtain a linear equation on Sn. And sometimes it turns out this equation sometimes can be solved. For example, if we take a spectral curve of genus one, this equation can be solved explicitly. And the coefficients of the operator for the two has such form. We take arbitrary functional parameter gamma of n. U of n can be expressed through gamma with the help of this formula, and W has such form. And one can check explicitly that L2 commutes with the operator of order three here. If we take spectral curve of genus greater than one, we can construct explicit examples. One of them is such operator. Here we see that the coefficients can be expressed in terms of trigonometric functions. This operator commutes with the operator of order 2g plus one. And by some reasons they commute, and we have a very beautiful formula, explicit formula. Another example, this operator commutes with the operator of order 2g plus one. Here we have operator with polynomial coefficients. And to find a connection between difference and differential case, we should replace shift operator by one, shift operator T by shift operator by epsilon. And everything is true as I explained before. And for example, if we take hyperelliptic spectral curve, we obtain a similar situation. We have operator of order two, which corresponds to the meromorphic function Z on this spectral curve. And again, we can obtain a theorem similar to this, this theorem, and with the help of this equation, analog of this equation, we can find operators. And in the case of elliptic curve, we obtain the following. This operator L2 commutes with the operator of order three, and here gamma of x epsilon is arbitrary functional parameter. And if we put here in this formula, instead of gamma, Weierstrass pi function shifted by minus epsilon, we obtain the following explicit difference operator. Here, zeta is a Weierstrass function. And it is remarkable fact that if we take a series for L2, the main term is the Lamé operator. So roughly speaking, if we substitute in this difference operator epsilon is equal to zero, we obtain the Lamé operator. And it is remarkable fact that spectral curve for this difference operator doesn't depend on epsilon. So we construct a discretization of the Lamé operator, which preserves the spectral curve. It's very interesting fact. And to construct a discretization of the Lamé operator for arbitrary coefficient near pi functions, we should consider the following coefficients of the difference operator. Let A1 is this function, A2 this function, and we construct Aj by this explicit formula if j is odd. And if g is even, we construct Aj by this formula. by this explicit formula. And to note that this operator L2 commutes with the operator of of order 2g plus 1. This is our main statement. And again, if we take a series for L2 with respect to epsilon, we obtain the Lame operator. Roughly speaking, if we substitute here epsilon is equal to zero, we obtain the Lame operator. How much? Very good. But we have also some partial results related to the Trebisch-Verdi operator. Trebisch-Verdi operator has such form, it is a finite gap operator. And we construct a discretization of this operator in the degenerated case. More precisely, we know that pi functions satisfy this nonlinear differential equation. And if we assume that right hand side has a multiple root, then a pi function is degenerated to 1 divided by sinus to the power 2 of x. So in the degenerated case, in the degenerated case, Trebisch-Verdi operators became the following form. Here we have trigonometric coefficients. This is the case of genus. Yes. As I remember, one of this A is equal to 1, another is equal to 2, and the third is equal to 0. So in this formula, we have a freedom for AI. And if you take a special AI, we obtain these coefficients 2 and 6. So more precisely, for example, A1 is equal to 1, A2 is equal to 2, and another A must be equal to 0. We obtain this operator in the degenerated case. And if we take A2 in such form, then this operator commutes with the operator of order 5. Here we have spectral curve of genus 2, singular spectral curve. And at epsilon is equal to 0, we obtain this degenerated Trebisch-Verdi operator. And in the end, maybe the last slide, I give you an explicit discretization of this operator, this polynomial coefficients. As I said, this operator of order 4 commutes with the operator of order 4g plus 2. Here we have a spectral curve of genus 2. And more or less similar method can be applicable to the higher rank operator. This is just example. This operator of order 4 commutes with the operator of order 4g plus 2. This pair has a rank 2. And if we substitute here epsilon is equal to 0, we obtain differential operators of rank 2. Okay, let me stop here.
My question about negative powers was arbitrary again. Because, for instance, if you consider systems like Ventura or the max operator, which is a bigger operator, which is positive and negative, generally polynomial. You don't have Laurent polynomial. Where you want to put Laurent polynomial to your construction, or you just have some assumption. In general, you know, I can give you an example of the consideration.
Laurent. Actually, maybe it is this, but I didn't think about this. I consider only restricted.
No, because you think like in the differential operator, you have only positive, forget about negative. When you have shift, you can consider also negative shift.
Yes, of course.
It's automatic. So probably there are more solutions to your problem, or maybe a little bit relaxed.
Mainly rank point, rank one, 1 point operators. Yes.
I think that if you have negative term, so when you have this negative term, the spectral curve, I think it's better to think of it as living in a closed level. And you need to join a point at infinity and a point at zero. That gives you this point. So I think it just doesn't do this. This is very special.
Actually, there is no complete classification of commuting difference operators. For example, I know spectral data, higher rank, such that the corresponding operators have only positive T. There are different traits when there are negative and there are only positive. There are no classifications.
Another thing you mentioned to the result of the Julian knowledge of spectral class 2 is actually used to change the Julian knowledge equation.
Yes. We have such equation.
So, also, I remember the number of papers by Alex Mohan, that is the higher rank.
Rank 3. Maybe it is a good exercise for students. I didn't do, yes. I'm sure that it's work awesome here. Actually, I don't know. Maybe there is some integrable system which related to this difference operators. I don't know. Mm-hmm.